Good afternoon to all. My name is T. Vamsiprasad, working as an assistant professor in Fame Management Engineering College in Business Department. Today I will give the lecture on semiconductors. So, in semiconductor, we are having a energy level diagram based on the band theory of solids related to the insulated semiconductors and conductors. The specialty of semiconductors is we having the electrical properties lies between the insulators and good conductor. So, in semiconductor, the pure type of semiconductor components are germanium and silicon. In germanium, the formidable band gap is in the order of 0.7 electron volts. In silicon is 1.1 electron volts. So here, a semiconductor material is it having the electrical properties like between the dielectric materials and conductor. So in semiconductor, when the temperature is increased, the forbidden band is decreased. So here, the band energy having the first the valency band. This is the valency band. The middle one is the forbidden band. The upper one is the conduction band. This is the conduction band. So in semiconductor, the forbidden band is very small. So what happens if the forbidden band is very small? When a small amount of energy is applied, these electrons can easily jump into the conduction band. So the importance of valency band is it is almost the fulfilled band. That means the band which is occupied by highest occupied energy band, the conduction band is always empty band. So here no electron can stay in this band. So in semiconductor, at T equal to 0 degree Kelvin, the material acts as a perfect insulator. At high temperature, the material acts as a good conductor. So the specialty of semiconductor devices is the resistance. Okay, the resistance of semiconductor devices decreases with increase of temperature. So here I am taking the resistance R equal to resistivity into L by A. So here the resistivity can be written as rho equal to R into A by L. So here in semiconductor, the resistivity is directly proportional to the area of the cross section and length of the conductor. So based on this property, semiconductor always having the negative temperature coefficient. So at this point, if you take the conductor having for positive temperature coefficient. So semiconductor having the negative temperature coefficient, conductor having for positive temperature coefficient. In conductor, we can call it as a metal. In metal, having for Ohm's law, J equal to sigma E. Okay, in this equation, J equal to sigma E, this sigma indicates the electrical conductivity. The electrical conductivity of current density into the applied electric field strength. So here, according to Ohm's law, the current density J is directly proportional to the electric field strength. So the sigma electrical conductivity can be written as sigma equal to N E square tau by M. So here tau is called the relaxation time, and M is the mass of the electron, L is the number of conduction electrons per unit volume, and sigma is the electrical conductivity. Based on this equation, I am representing the semiconductor, the current density equation J equal to sigma E. So I am writing here J equal to sigma equal to N E mu into E. This electrical conductivity is equal to N E mu. Mu is called the mobility of the electron. Okay, the mobility is directly proportional to the electrical conductivity. The mobility of the electron mu equal to sigma by n. So based on these factors, I am calculating here semiconductors on carrier concentration. Carrier concentration to find out the carrier concentration for intrinsic semiconductor and extrinsic semiconductor. So here the semiconductors can be classified into the two types. First one is pure semiconductors and second one is impure semiconductors. Okay, pure semiconductor is again classified into the p-type material, that is p-type semiconductor and n-type semiconductor. So pure semiconductor is also called the intrinsic semiconductor. Impure semiconductor is also called for extrinsic semiconductor. Here extrinsic semiconductor, the meaning of extrinsic semiconductor is when a small amount of pentavalent atom and trivalent atom is added to the pure semiconductor crystal, its electrical conductivity property should be changed. That's why p-type semiconductor having for dot block elements, n-type semiconductor having for fifth block elements. So here n-type material, when a small amount of pentavalent impurity is added to the pure semiconductor crystal, the resulting crystal is called for n-type semiconductor. In p-type semiconductor, when a small amount of trivalent element is added to the pure semiconductor crystal, the resulting crystal is called for p-type semiconductor. In p-type semiconductor, the examples are boron, okay, boron and phosphorus. N-type metal, the examples are arsenic, antimony, bismuth. These are all the examples related to the p-type and n-type semiconductor. Now I am better to take next the intrinsic semiconductor and calculating the carrier concentration for electron density and force density. Based on this factor, I am taking the here intrinsic semiconductor. In intrinsic semiconductor, I am calculating the carrier concentration. Calculating for carrier concentration. Now in this carrier concentration, what is the important for carrier concentration based on the pure semiconductors and impure semiconductors? The importance of carrier concentration is the number of electrons in the conduction band is equal to the number of holes in the valency band per unit volume of the material is called for carrier concentration, or we can call density of charge carriers. Density of charge carriers. The importance of carrier concentration is the number of electrons in the conduction band and the number of holes in the valency band per unit volume of the material is called carrier concentration, or we can call density of charge carriers. In this density of charge carriers, first I am calculating the electron density in the conduction band. First I am calculating the electron density of electrons in the density of electrons in the conduction band, and one more is density of holes in the valency band. So here the importance of density of electrons in conduction band, density of holes in the valency bond will depend upon the density of states in the top bottom of the valency band and top of the conduction band. I am representing here the density of electrons in the conduction band is d n equal to z of e into f of e d In this one, I am calculating the density of electron in the conduction band. Ze indicates the density of state. Density of states in the energy state. Okay. In this one, Z of E. I am writing density of states equal to 4 pi by h cube into 2m whole power 3 by 2 into e power 1 by 2 into d. Now look at here, the density of states is directly proportional to the energy state E, and it is directly proportional to the mass of the electron. H is the Planck constant. One more equation is F of E. F of E is called the Fermi Dirac distribution for the energy state. The equation is 1 by 1 plus exponential equal to E minus EF by KT. 1 by 1 plus exponential power E minus EF by KT. Here E is the energy state, EF is the Fermi energy, and K is the Boltzmann constant, and T is the absolute temperature. So after the substituting these values, we are finding the density of states in the conduction band N equal to, I am writing final equation, 2 into 2 pi m e star kt by h square whole power 3 by 2 into exponential power e minus EF by K B T E C minus EF by K B T. This is the equation for the density of electrons in the conduction band. Similarly, we can write density of holes in the valency band equal to 2 into 2 pi M H star K T by H square whole power 3 by 2 into exponential power minus EV by EF by KT. The importance of this equation is, here ME star is called the effective mass of the electron, MH star is called the effective mass of the hole. That means the mass of the electron is coming into the periodic potential. The mass of the electron is converted into the effective mass of the electron in density of electron. In same light, the mass of the hole is converted into the effective mass of the hole. So in these two equations, I am representing here one more factor is Fermi energy of intrinsic semiconductor, that is EF equal to EC plus EV by 2. Here the importance of Fermi level is, the Fermi level is the intermediate state between the bottom of the valency band and top of the conduction band. This is the EF, that is Fermi energy. EF can be written as, this is our valency band, that is the bottom of the valency band, this is the conduction band. So the Fermi level is the intermediate state between the bottom of the valency band and top of the conduction band. This equation is valid at temperature T equal to 0 degree Kelvin. So here, according to the temperature dependence of intrinsic semiconductor will depends upon the N equal to 2 into 2 pi K divided by H square whole power 3 by 2 into, I am writing here exponential power equal to minus Eg by 2 KT into, we can write here T power 3 by 2 into, we can write here ME star into MH star whole power 3 by 4. So here, before that, the semiconductor is always having the negative temperature coefficient. In that one, the energy gap Eg equal to You can write here Eg equal to Ec minus Eb. Okay, so in this equation you can represent N for density of electron, density of hole, so it will be energy and energy gap, and also the energy gap in the function of the temperature dependence, that is P power 3 by 2. Okay, for thank you.